This is the SAP Developer News for July the 10th, 2025.
Hi there, and welcome from St. Leon Roth in Germany, just down the road from the mothership in Waldorf. We're here at Code Connect 2025. It's Wednesday. It's been an amazing week so far, starting with, on Monday, what, Ajay?
So, hello everyone, welcome. And on Monday, we had two code jams running in parallel, one for CAP and one for UI5. And we had jam-packed rooms, and it was really exciting to see all of you there. And it was a very good weather as well. Over to you, Nico.
Thanks. Yeah, so the day after, on Tuesday, we had UI5Con, and my personal highlight was meeting many of you, the developers, and talk tech. And also my to-do list of things I want to try out is getting longer and longer the longer the week gets. It's just so much inspiration out here. So that was very cool. And what happened today, DJ?
What happened today, that's Wednesday, was Recap 2025. I love this event. I love Code Connect generally, but specifically Recap. Again, just like Nico, meeting you folks, but learning from you folks, learning from everybody from the sessions, from the corridor conversations. It's just humbling to see so many big brains and so many humble people, so many modest people here at the event. And we've got something special tomorrow as well as part of the Code Connect event. What is it, Vitaly?
So for the very first time, Code Connect family is getting a new child, which is HANA TechCon. And we are really looking for that because the idea came to us last year during the Code Connect. And we really wanted to get HANA into the family of all the other technologies at SAP. So probably you're looking at this on Friday, and we are recording this on Wednesday, and the event is happening for HANA TechCon tomorrow. So I don't know what would be the proper English phrase to welcome all of those who are watching on Friday for the event that is going to happen tomorrow while we are recording on Wednesday. Have it happened yet?
A universal welcome. How about that? A universal welcome.
A universal welcome.
Okay. So that's us wrapping it up. It's now time for the post-recap celebrations downstairs. So we're off now. Have a great evening, great morning, great afternoon. Bye for now.
Cheers.
Cheers. Bye.
Fast forward to Thursday, and here I am at HANA TechCon. As we mentioned, it is the very first time we have it. I'm really glad there are many participants joining. There are many people watching this live. And as well, rest assured that we will provide recordings available for you as well. I would like to welcome as well our SAP community team here. If you didn't get a chance, or if you haven't had a chance to visit their table here today and to collect all these beautiful stickers, make sure that you stop by one of our SAP CodeJams this year and you get them as well.
Hi there, folks. So we're at Recap 2025, part of Code Connect this week here in St. Leon Roth, and I'm very happy to have grabbed Ola for a short time, Ola Lilienthal, head of the CAP organization. And I'm going to ask Ola to talk to us a little bit about one of the topics in his opening talk this morning. So Ola, welcome, first of all.
Thank you so much, DJ, for having me.
Well, thanks for being here. So one of the topics which came hand in hand with the annual major release of CAP, which is CAP 9, Node.js 9, which was out in May this year, right?
Right.
Also at the same time, there's a new developer license 3.2 CAP, is that right?
Right, that's great.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Of course. Thanks for giving me the opportunity. Look, there have been a lot of customers and partners approaching us in the past and asking us specific questions about how they can use CAP and in which scenario.
Yeah.
And actually, there was some ambiguity in that license, in the old license, and the developer license. And so we had two ways of handling it. One was we always get into discussions with legal to get explanations of how to interpret that license.
Yes. Yeah.
And to then give answers to customers, but you don't really want to be in that situation to interpret legal tech.
It doesn't help you
to give your customers answers, right? So the second approach was let's get those ambiguities fixed. Let's work on that license. So we got together with legal and we formulated some things differently in that CUP-specific developer license. And the gist of it is basically that if you're using CUP as a developer for testing purposes, for developing purposes, for educational purposes,
research,
anything, you can do that. We are happy to for you to use CUP and try it out. If you're making money with it, if you're using it in a productive scenario, we want you to do that or let the productive application run on an SAP license, but right.
Yeah.
So today this is either SAP BTP or also XSA. And that's what we ask you. And in return, we make it really clear that if you do so, you get full support for that CAP application on that platform from us as SAP.
That's great. I mean, that's a nice, clear direction. The door's not completely closed yet, right?
So
it's a journey.
Yes. So we are still discussing about the process of open sourcing CUP further.
Yep.
As you all might know, we had a lot of CUP components which we open sourced in the past over the last years. And so that journey is still kind of ongoing. But there are a lot of discussions in how far we go here. If we also open source the core of CUP, and that's still kind of an open journey, I would say.
Yeah,
and you still continue on that journey, but it's not really decided.
Exactly. And in the meantime, we have the CAP.js org on GitHub, and that's, the nearest part of the journey. Okay. Well, you heard it here first, folks. So, Ole, thanks very much for joining us.
Thanks so much.
I think it's now time for a maybe a small beer.
Maybe a small old beverage.
We're cold beverage, yes. Beverage of choice. Okay, thanks, Ola.
Thanks so much.
Great.
Hey, everybody. It's Josh Bentley. I'm a community advocate, and I'm with
Anne,
who is also a community advocate. And we're so happy to be reporting live from the beautiful SAP campus here in Waldorf, Germany. We're prepping for one of our favorite events, which is SAP TechEd. It's going to be on site in Berlin, November 4th through 6th. And we've got a couple of great things that are being promoted by our colleague, Cecilia Wergo, with some blog posts. Lots of information to talk about. And I'm going to let Anne tell you about one of the great things you can submit right now. What is it?
We're bringing back the SAP Community Talks. Do you want to share or talk about anything you've learned, experiences, cool demos you built, technology you worked with? This is your opportunity to submit a talk. The submission date is July 14th. It's coming up shortly, so think fast. It's a Monday.
You have all weekend.
All weekend to work on your submission. Then on July 22nd, we will let all everyone know the submission status, if it was accepted or declined. As part of the process, you'll be assigned a developer advocate who will help you through the process.
Kind of like a buddy, just to help you get set up in the community theater, which will be on site in our community clubhouse.
Yes. And the developer advocate will reach out to you at the end of July.
So we're going to have 20 of these available. These are talks of 20 minutes. And what's really cool is you get what's called a lecture pass. So it's a free ticket to be on site in Berlin. We do not cover travel and expense, but you will be able to go onto the show floor as a speaker and attend everything happening at TechEd. The lecture pass does not entitle you to the hands-on workshops. Those you can actually increase your access by paying the difference in price between the free ticket and a full price pass. The other thing we have is another huge community favorite coming back on stage, DemoJam. So,
yes.
Lots of people are going to want to be on stage in DemoJam, showcasing all the great things they build with BTP, all the great code that they know about, and that they can do things with BTP. The trick is you need to actually get a lot of team members together and submit a proposal that we can look at and see if it's going to be one of the ones we select. And this process is happening now through the end of July, July 31st. Once that's done, we're going to go into a selection committee and then do some interviews and select different teams that we will then invite to be on stage. The top six, yes, six will be on stage, and you'll have 6 minutes and you will not be allowed to go over, and we'll buzz you off stage. And then after that, we'll have our applause meter and it will judge who the best one was and the winner of DemoJam, and you'll get the trophy if we can find it.
If we can find it.
Yes, exactly. It's somewhere around here. So that's it. We've got DemoJam tickets as well. So the top teams that are selected, those six teams will get to have two people on stage with the same lecture passes.
And remember, no slides.
Exactly.
No slides. No AI-generated content.
Yes.
Real thing.
Real thing, real people, real community connecting.
Yeah.
All right. We will see you in Berlin. Bye.
Bye.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. We're here at Code Connect, and I happen to bump into Simon, who just last week published the CDS MCP plugin. So who's better to introduce it than Simon himself?
Yeah, thank you. The CAP MCP plugin is basically a plugin that allows you to handle model context protocol for your OData service directly in CAP. It's plug and play. And yeah, check out the link in the description.
All right. Hope to talk to you soon. Bye.
Hello, everybody. Are you looking to step up your central point of entry user experience from SAP Build Workzone Standard Edition, which was previously called SAP Fiori Launchpad, to SAP Build Workzone Advanced Edition on SAP BTP? Then here is an in-depth structured guidance to achieve the same. In this blog post written by our SAP Build Workzone product manager Yumna Abbasi, you could understand the overview of SAP Build Workzone Standard Edition and SAP Build Workzone Advanced Edition. The key differences between these two offerings: information regarding the subscription and service plans, end-to-end transition path. Under transition, crucial steps like accessing the current implementation, planning the migration, exporting the content, setting up SAP Build Workzone Advanced Edition, content migration, how to use the existing configurations, best practices to follow during implementation, testing, validation, change management, and go live are well documented. Get ready to provide your business users a multimedia-rich user experience with SAP Build Workzone Advanced Edition. For more details, refer to the blog post. Link is provided in the description box. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. We are doing a SAP CodeJam Roadshow in the Southeast Asia region, and the first stop is Singapore. We did two CodeJams, one on ABAP Cloud and RESTful Application Programming Model, and the other one, Generative AI Hub on SAP AI Core. It was a good mix of SAP customers and partners, making it a true community event. How was your experience, Sheena?
It was great, Shilpa, and what I loved the most is that they follow our SAP Developers YouTube channel and they like our content.
That's so cool, right? And where are you heading next?
So I'm heading to Kuala Lumpur first, where Shini will join me, and then we'll both fly together to Bangkok for the next set of CodeJams. Good luck.
Thank you.
We are in the SAP Thailand office in Bangkok, where we just finished the SAP GenAI CodeJam. Before coming here, we were in Kuala Lumpur, where we conducted the SAP Build CodeJam. So Shini, how did you feel about the SAP CodeJam Roadshow across Southeast Asia?
This is the first time we are doing a CodeJam in this region. We've had many of our SAP developers from our customers and partners attend these events. It was exciting to hear their feedback and discuss the latest innovations happening in their BTP space, especially on SAP Brilliant and GenAI topics. So yeah, it was interesting CodeJam. So Sheena, what is happening next week?
Yeah, the team is having a jam-packed schedule with Antonio traveling to India to join Ajay for the next set of Integration Suite CodeJam Roadshow across various locations in India. So stay tuned for further updates.